Hey, what's up everyone? This is Power Owner and today we're back with another video here on Hypixel Skyblock, and today we're going to be taking a look at what are the best weapons to use in 2021, and I hope you guys are excited for it. Obviously, we're going to be taking a look at early game weapons, mid game weapons, and then late game weapons. In addition to that, we're going to be also including some bonus tips at the very end of the video, so make sure you stick around till the end. So let's start with the early game weapons, and the price range here is from 0 coins up to 200,000 coins, and the very first item that we have here is Silver Fang. Now Silver Fang does 100 damage. Oh my god. Okay, well that was a little bit concerning because we do have very, very expensive weapons at the very end there, so this better not happen again. Now luckily this is one of the cheapest ones, which cost only 9,000 coins, and well, as you guys can see, it actually does 100 damage, which is pretty decent. Now initially I thought that I'm gonna be showing how much damage we're gonna be doing, but I realized that this really depends on your skill levels, fairy souls, talismans, and all that. So instead, we're just going to be talking about these items as it is. So the next item on the list is Aspect of the End. And well, this one right here, what the heck? Why do they keep disappearing? This is actually concerning. Anyways, let's stay on the topic. The weapon that I wanted to show you guys is Aspect of the End. And it does cost 190,000 coins. But with that weapon, you're going to be getting 100 damage and 100 strength. Moving on, the next item on the list is the Raider Axe. Now, the Raider Axe is pretty freaking amazing because of its ability. Yo. And well, as you guys can see, this does cost only about 150,000 coins, but every single time you're gonna be killing a monster, you're gonna be gaining 20 coins, which is pretty decent. You can make a little bit of extra money when grinding, let's say, sea lots or slayers, whatever it may be. But anyways, with this weapon, you're gonna be getting 80 damage and 150 strength, meaning that it's pretty strong, but you can actually increase the strength by actually getting wood from the collections, which makes this weapon quite a bit better. In addition to that, it does have a kill counter, which also makes the weapon a little bit stronger. So this is something that you want to look out for. Anyways, moving on to the mid-game weapons, which I'm not sure if I want to take them out because we might lose them. But we have the first one, which is Warped Aspect of the End. Now, this one is a little bit more expensive. It does cost 9 million coins. With this weapon, you're going to be gaining 265 damage, 265 strength, and 50% crit chance. Now this is very decent, especially if you actually started out in the early game with the Aspect of the End. Once you actually have enough money for yourself to buy the Warp Reforge, you can put it on, which does cost quite a bit. And in total, well, you can buy this sword for about 9 million coins. But if you're mid game and you consider 9 million to be too much, well, the next weapon would be Aspect of the Dragons, because it does cost only about 1.2 million coins. And with this sword, you're going to be getting 225 damage and strength 100. Now, this is definitely very decent considering that you're going to be paying only 1.2 million coins. But if you do have the money, I would highly recommend Warped Aspect of the End over the Aspect of the Dragons. Now the next item on the list is actually a dungeon weapon, which is the Livid Dagger. And if you guys didn't know, Livid Dagger does cost a little bit more. Now this weapon right here costs about 6.8 million coins, which is still cheaper than Warp Aspect of the End. But as you guys can see, with this weapon right here, you're going to be doing damage 210, strength 60, crit chance 100%, great damage 50%, and bonus attack speed of 100%. As you guys can see, you do definitely get quite a bit of abilities, and also the ability of this weapon is you can actually throw this right here. And well, with this, you can do quite a bit of damage. Anyways, now that's gone, we're gonna move on to the endgame weapon. Now before we do that, I do wanna quickly say that we're on the road to 50,000 subscribers and it's completely free to subscribe. So make sure you guys do subscribe with the notifications on because I'm doing daily Hypixel Skyblock videos. And also smash that like button for the YouTube algorithm. But anyways, let's move on to the endgame weapons. So over here we have the bad boys, which are pretty expensive, except for the middle one, which is the Emerald Blade. But in a second, I'm gonna talk a little bit more about it, why it's actually a really good late game weapon. But the first one on the list is a Dirt Block, but instead of Dirt Block, I do actually mean Giant Sword. Now, as you guys can see, this sword is pretty pricey, but fairly cheap compared to the rest, which we're gonna be showing. Now, this sword does do quite a bit of damage. As you guys can see, the base damage is 500, and well, that is pretty strong, especially inside of dungeon. Now, the typical price for it is about 90 million coins, but right now it does seem to go for more than 90 million coins. But as you guys can see, it is on around about 100 million coins. Anyways, as you guys can see, the mythic one, which is a tiny bit more expensive, about 5 million coins more expensive, your damage is going to be 1600 and strength 200 with the Withered Reforge. Now, this is definitely very strong, and well, the base damage is going to be even stronger depending on your catacombs level. Now, the next item on the list would mean that you would need to have quite a bit of coins in your purse in order for it actually to be good. If you guys didn't know, the base damage of this weapon right here is only 130, and well, it does cost only 350,000 coins. But how much coins in your inventory really makes this weapon a lot different. So as I mentioned, the base damage of this is 130, but take a look at me with 192 million coins in the purse. Well, the damage is going to be 424. Now, this is pretty decent damage, and well, this weapon does cost only 350,000 coins, but you need a lot of cash for it to be actually good. Therefore, if you have like about 500 million coins, this will definitely be worth it. But if you're looking with about 200 million coins, it's way wiser to actually go for the giant sword. Anyways, moving on to the very last weapon on the list, which is a very expensive weapon, and hopefully we're not gonna repeat the mistake that we did with the early game weapons. Anyways, let me open up this GUI, and the whoa, my god, that was scary. But the weapon that we are talking about is the Valkyrie. Now, this weapon's price is 580 million coins, but as you guys can see, the damage is pretty freaking amazing. Now, this weapon does have some hot potato books on it. Right now, the damage is 322, strength 364, and 60% crit damage. In addition to that, there is Intelligence 60 and Ferocity 65. But it does have the Withered Reforge, which makes it a little bit better, especially with strength. But as you guys can see, this weapon is very good in the dungeons. And also, if your catacombs level is pretty high up there, well, you can actually do even more damage and more strength thanks to this weapon. So if you have a very high catacombs, this weapon is definitely worth it. Now, mine is only level 22, so the stats are not as good, and that's one of the reasons why I'm not really displaying how much damage we are able to do, because once again, this all comes into consideration. So those were the late game weapons, but now moving on to the bonus tips that you guys have been waiting for. And well, the first tip is that don't put any tier 6 to 7 enchants onto your weapons if you're mid game or early game. Just save them up until your late game, because these weapons, well, while they're good during this time, well, it's better to save them up for the late game unless you're just trying to flex. The second tip is for the people who have reached mid game or even are in the late game. There are a few more weapons that you should be considering to have. And well, firstly, these are the Reaper Falchion and Scorpion Foil, and this is purely for the Slayers. If you guys didn't know, they do an insane amount of damage during Slayers with these weapons. Scorpion Foil is for the spiders, and Reaper Falchion is for the zombies. And I do use these swords to this day, and they are extremely valuable, and I actually did upload a video where I'm talking about how to prepare for a new update, because we're going to be getting a new Slayers update. You can click on the screen right now and watch it after this video. But anyways, the last two tips are, don't forget to put the right reforges on your weapons, that can make a huge difference. And of course, don't forget that hot potato books do exist, because they can make it way better, and also fuming potato books. You can put down, I think, 5 fuming potato books and 10 hot potato books, so don't forget that. It does cost a little bit, but hot potato books prices have gone down enormously, so they are pretty affordable to everybody, and buying 10 of them, well, that's gonna cost you only about 400,000. But anyways, there it was. I hope you guys have enjoyed today's video, and I wanna say a huge thank you to everybody who has watched this video till the very end. You guys are freaking amazing, and if you're new to the channel, haven't subscribed yet, make sure you guys do subscribe with the notifications on, because I'm doing daily uploads. Anyways, thanks so much for watching. Hope to see you guys in the next one. Peace out.